Hello everyone, DonellHD here. Today I'm going to show you how to set up, configure, and install the Nintendo 3DS Emulator Citra on Launchbox. I have my arcade folder here, and inside my arcade folder, I have my Launchbox folder, the Emulators folder, and the ROMs folder where we're going to be keeping our ROMs. I left a link in the description below to the Citra website where you can download the emulator. Just click here on download. Alright, I've downloaded the program and I've placed it here on my desktop. Now I'm going to run it. Just go ahead and go through the process as you normally would with any other program. And make sure you select the directory where you want it to be installed. Next, here is where you select your version. I'm going to choose the nightly version. If you feel like you need to choose the canary version, then you go ahead and use that one instead. Click next, license agreement, accept the license. Next, next, and let it install. Once you're done, you click finish. Okay, I've opened my emulator folder. I'm going to run Citra for the first time. I'm going to go in the Citra folder here. I'm going to go into the nightly-mingw folder. And before I run the program, I'm going to create a folder in here and name it user because I want my program to be portable. Now that I've created a user folder, I'm going to go ahead and run the emulator now by clicking on the Citra-QT.exe here. When the program first opens up, it asks you, would you like to share data with them? I'm going to say no. You can choose whichever you like. Okay, the first thing I'm going to do is go here to view. Screen layout, and I'm going to select side by side. Then I'm going to go here to emulation, configure, graphics tab, and I'm going to increase my resolution to around 4x. And I'm also going to change my texture filter. You can change yours according to however you think your PC can handle it. Then I'm going to go to controls. I'm going to fast forward here a little bit while I configure my controls. I'm using an Xbox 360 controller. And the mouse controls the touchpad on the 3DS. Once I'm done, I'm going to click on the hotkeys tab here. And I'm going to change exit full screen to alternate enter. And I'm going to change exit Citra to escape. Then I'm going to press OK when I'm done. Now it's time to import our ROMs into Citra. So what I'm going to do is double click here to add a new folder to the game list. I'm going to select where my ROMs are, desktop, arcade, ROMs. I'm going to click select folder, and then all my games pop up. Now it's time to set this emulator up in Launchbox. Alright, now that we're here in Launchbox, we're going to go up here to the three lines at the top left corner. We're going to go to Tools, Manage, Emulators. I'm going to go to Add. The name of our emulator is Citra. The application path. Once again, it's on my desktop, arcade, emulator, Citra, nightly-mingw folder, and the Citra-QT.exe here. Gonna go to associated platforms, and I'm gonna name the associated platform Nintendo 3DS. I'm gonna select this as my default emulator. Then I'm gonna go to the running script area, and I've included a script in the description below that automatically makes the emulator go full screen, and when you press the escape key, it exits out of the emulator. So I'm gonna paste it here, and then I'm gonna click OK, and then close. Now it's time to import our games into Launchbox. This time I'm gonna do the drag and drop method again, and I'm just gonna take my three ROMs, and I'm gonna drag them into the Launchbox here. I'm gonna click ROM files. What platform are you importing games for? Nintendo 3DS. Click next. My emulator is Citra. Next. I'm going to use their files in their current location. Next. 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 I'm going to make sure my ROMs are spelled correctly. And then I'm going to click finish. Now that the games are installed, it's time to test out the games. Here's Dragon Ball Fusions. And here's Transformers Prime. And we've come to the end of our video. Thank you everyone for watching. If this video helped you out at all, support the channel and drop a like and subscribe. I've created more tutorials for other emulators as well. you can click on the thumbnails on the screen. As always, I'm DonellHD, and I'll see you guys in the next video. Take care.